Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Today I am back in front of the camera. By your blessings, first of all of you, please accept my greetings, my best wishes for the year 2016. So, I would be reading from Bhagavad Gita as it is, chapter 4, Transcendental Knowledge, Divya Gyan, and verse number 5. We have covered previously up to verse number 4. And today we are in verse number 5. Shri Bhagavan Vacha, Bahuni Nidya Titani Janmani Tavcha Arjuna, Tanya Ahavid Sarvani Natvam Vitha Parantapa. The Blessed Lord said, O Arjuna, both you and me have passed many births, many lifetimes. I remember all of them. Tanya aham ved sarvani. All of them I remember. Natvam vetha parantapa. O parantapa, subduer of the enemies. O Arjuna, you can't remember all of them, but I remember. It's very interesting verse. And there is a plenty to speak about this verse. Now, we have to go little bit in the background also. Remember previously, Arjuna is saying that, oh my Lord, how is that possible that you gave this knowledge, which you are now giving it to me, you gave this knowledge to Sun God, Vivasman, how is that? And in answer to that, Krishna is speaking this verse. Though Krishna gave this knowledge around 120 million years ago to Sun God Vivasvan, but Krishna remembers it. Krishna remembers all of his incarnation. Krishna has many, many forms and he remembers. Even Arjuna was also there, but Arjuna does not remember. In the purport, His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada has said that when Krishna gave this knowledge of Bhagavad Gita to Sun God Vivasvan, Arjuna was there, present in some capacity, but he cannot remember. So Prabhupada is saying, here is the difference, the gulf of difference between living entity and the Supreme Lord. Someone may be liberated like Arjuna. Arjuna is a pure devotee of the Lord. Krishna is saying that Bhaktovasi me sakha cha iti. You are my devotee and you are my friend and you are my relative as well. Krishna didn't say to Arjuna that you are my relative. I just made it up. Anyway, so Krishna gave this knowledge to Arjuna. And so when it said that I am giving you that same yoga purokta puratana, that ancient yoga, ancient knowledge I am sharing with you. So first of all, Krishna is saying that it is not that I have manufactured something recently. I just made it up, something concoction. I am giving you that knowledge, the same knowledge which was given to Sun God. And I am giving to you. So Arjuna is saying, but how is that possible? Because you are contemporary to me. Whereas Sun God is very senior to you by birth. Remember he said that verse number 4. Arjuna vacha aparam bhavatu janama param janam vivasvata katham etad vijaniya tvam ado praptavaniti. And now Krishna is speaking the authority. So now this is really very interesting that in this chapter 4, altogether there are 42 verses and the first 3 verses are spoken by Lord Krishna. Then verse number 4 is spoken by Arjuna where he is inquiring. And then Krishna again starts from verse number 5 and he goes up to verse number 42. See, Krishna is having upper hand in this chapter. Just one verse is spoken by Arjuna and 41 verses are spoken by Lord Krishna. In verse number 4, Arjuna placed his inquiry before the Lord And Krishna started giving answer from this verse number 5th. So we can see that Krishna's knowledge is just so much. He's just hankering to give this knowledge so to Arjuna, that he spoke so much. He just asked one question and Krishna gave him answer in 38 verses. And this is battlefield. What would have happened if Arjuna would have placed this question in some peaceful situation? In battlefield, Krishna is giving such a detailed answer. Of course, he covered many other points also. But Arjuna asked one question. How is that, my Lord, you gave this knowledge to sun god? And Krishna started. And when Krishna speaks, everyone has to listen. So, here is my speculation that in the end of this chapter, Krishna could have asked Arjuna, my dear Arjuna, is there any other question on this subject matter? And Arjuna could have said, my Lord, that was enough. You spoke very well. So, we should appreciate this verse number 5th. Shri Bhagavan Vacha, Bahuni Mevyati Tani, Janmani Tav Charjuna. Interesting thing is that Krishna is saying, Bahuni Mevyati Tani. My birth, my and your. In Sanskrit, Krishna is saying my first, but in English, as it is etiquette of the language, Krishna is saying both you and me. So Krishna is talking about himself after Arjuna. As you know, in English, I cannot say I and my brother. I have to say my brother and I. So Krishna is saying, though in Sanskrit it is first for Krishna, Bahuni me, me, my. Tav, you, it comes after Krishna. But in English it became, both you and me have passed many, many births. But I remember all of them and you cannot. O Parantapa, subduer of the enemies. So, Krishna is saying that, O mighty arm Arjuna, by material calculation, material estimation, you are quite strong fellow. You are afflicter of the enemies. Par tapaha, par, other than oneself, antagonist, enemies, tapa, tapyati, you are scorching them. O scorcher of the foes, you are heating your enemy up by the rays of the heat of your prowess. You are so powerful that you are afflicting them. O scorcher of the foes, Parantapa, you are very powerful. But see, you cannot remember. So Srila Prabhupada is saying that here is the difference between Supreme Lord and the living entity like Arjuna. That he cannot remember. So because when living entity takes birth, another birth, they change body. But Supreme Lord's body is same. Ishvara Prama, Ishvara Parama Krishna, Satchidananda Vigraha, Anadir Adir Govindo, Sarva Karan Karanam. He has that same Satchidananda body. Krishna's body is identical with soul, Advaya Tattva, Advaita. So Krishna remembers all of his previous incarnation, whereas Arjuna does not. Now, we should not think that Arjuna is in illusion about the potency of Lord Shri Krishna. He further reveals in chapter 10 when he says, Param Brahma, Param Dhamam, Pavitram Param Bhavan. Arjuna has a full knowledge about Krishna, that he is Supreme Brahman. Krishna is fountain head of everything, is above the modes of material nature, free from the effect of time and space. And Arjuna knew this thing. He had heard it from Bhishma and other saintly persons during Rasuya Yajna. He knew it. He has been to heaven and he had received instruction from his heavenly father Indra. So he is very well aware of the supreme position of Lord Shri Krishna. But he's just asking question so that Krishna will speak himself about himself. See, such auspicious moment when God speaks himself about himself. In that way, there is no room left for the people who distort the image of Krishna and thus mislead the public in general. So Krishna is saying that, O Arjuna, I give this knowledge to Sun God, and Sun God gave it to Manu Maharaj, and Manu Maharaj gave it to Ikshvaku, and the knowledge was received in this way, and somehow there was a discontinuation of this knowledge. So now I am re-establishing that same thing. I am giving this knowledge to you because you are my friend and my devotee. So Arjuna saying, yes sir, I accept, I am your devotee. But kindly tell me, how this happened? How is that Sun God is very senior to you by birth and you are just contemporary to me? Please tell me how it is possible. So then here Krishna is answering, O Arjuna, do not think that though this knowledge is 120 million years old, it was spoken by someone else. No, I was there. I gave this knowledge to him. And you were also there. But you can't remember. And I remember. So this is chapter number 4 and verse number 5. And from verse number 5, Krishna is speaking continuously till verse number 42. Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Srila Prabhupada ki jai.